The moment is here. The moment is here. Okay. Hello, music lovers. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for clicking on yet another video. My name is Peter. Oh, I got a pen. My name is Peter, and today we are reacting to The Weeknd. And it is, in fact, The Weeknd. Today, it's Friday. We're reacting to his new album called Dawn FM, you know, and I'm ready to get into it. Let's quickly talk about the cover art. He looks like an old man, and he's been very into face modifications. He did that whole thing of a bloody face during the After Hours era. This picture reminds me of what Moses Sumney did for the Me in 20 Years music video. He did that really, really well. If you've not seen that, go look that up. We're just gonna get into the music. I'm gonna talk about the music as we go on. Let's not do too much talking in the beginning. We're gonna start with the first track. It's called Dawn FM. I'm gonna try not to like pause too much in between and let the songs flow into each other because I know his transitions are sick. He's probably going to be doing a lot of the 80s music that he's been doing. This is loud. Since Starboy and After Hours. But I'm expecting a little difference. I'm expecting this to be very dance heavy. I hope this album has more singing than like the rap singing, because I love what The Weeknd like sings. Think of Scared to Live, think of True Colors.
You are now listening to 103.5 Dawn FM.
Okay. Okay. My phone is ringing. Oh my god. Let's start the song over. This is Gasoline. This does sound like the beginning of something. Okay. Like I said, this is disco, not just 80s music. This is disco. More like late 70s. Which I'm into. It's 5 a.m.
my time again. I've soaked up the moon, Kirsten.
What?
It's 5 a.m. my time again. I'm calling and you know it's me.
You know it's me. I love that. I like that he's doing something really different. No one else is doing this right now. Oh, not like he is. Breathe. I like that. It's like a roller coaster. I have no idea what the song is about. I'll tell you. I heard Apocalypse somewhere there. Ooh. I heard something about sleeping. I heard something about You Won't Let Me OD. But I'll tell you, the song, it's very easy breezy, like I'm thinking roller skating. I'm thinking very colorful. But I'm not really getting any like it's not a heavy hitter. But it's nice, I like it. That was good. That was good. I like that. Ooh. Mushroom tea. One thing about him, he loves the drug. You know what? This sounds like what, what's her name? Jessie Ware. This sounds like it's in the same family as Jessie Ware's last album. I can't remember what it is. But this sounds like that. How do I make you love me? How do I make you love me? Hey. Let's go. I like this one has a stronger chorus. I love a good strong chorus. Hey. Okay. I'll tell you already so far, I feel like this is a more optimistic album than After Hours. The lyrics sound more happy, more forward looking. Oh, that was good. That transition, hold on. I love that. I like that synth in the background. Okay. Sounds like a DJ. Like a DJ is mixing. Ooh. That sounds like the beginning of Booty Wishes by Destiny's Child. This goes into Take My Breath, which I think we've heard before. It's the only single from this, right? I didn't know it started like this, though. Take my breath. Oh, is this the extended version? Oh, I love this. Yes. I love that he, with this song, it takes its time. Like, we're a minute in, and the verse hasn't started.
I saw the fire in your eyes. I saw the fire in
your. And the vocals are more present on the song. I like this. This being the first single makes a lot of sense. It's like a dream. What she feels with me, she loves to be on the edge. I say this is a great first single. He didn't promote it enough though. I feel like it came and went. But anyway, we love the song. Lie. He still sounds like Michael Jackson. I guess it's just his voice. Take my breath away. This sounds like a rave. I feel like David Guetta would make such a beautiful remix to this song. Put a Nicki Minaj feature on it. I'm not trying to start anything. I'm just saying. What is he saying? I like that. Sing, Abel. You better sing. He's singing. Take it higher. He did not take it higher. Okay. And now we're on to Sacrifice, track 5. Take My Breath was great. I was born in a city for the winter nights don't ever sleep. I will say he needs to take the BPM down a bit. Cause it's gonna get a bit jarring. Like for all the songs to sound like this. Everything is which, you know. This literally sounds like a Michael Jackson song. All the songs have been love songs so far. I wonder if he's in love. Abel, you got a secret? trying to sing this bridge. Oh, that was a quick skip. This is called A Tale by Quincy. I'm guessing Quincy Jones. Who is?
Looking back now, I didn't know who it was supposed to be. Who was a collaborator
of Michael Jackson?
Rage, you don't know how to rage, you know? I don't know what the fuck I was doing. I didn't.
Is he talking about love?
I will never forget watching my mother get put in a straitjacket and taken out of my home when I was only 7 years old.
Oh no.
She was diagnosed with dementia praecox and put in a mental institution, leaving my daddy along with me and my little brother Lloyd. I later had an evil stepmother who further cemented the idea that I didn't need a mother. Growing up, whenever I got too close to the woman, I would cut her off. Part of that was vindictive and partially based on fear.
That was sad that that happened to her. Ooh, that was a beautiful transition. This is Out of Time. So far, this has my favorite production. I like how it's groovy. You know, it's a slow jam. But you can dance to it.
There's so much trauma in my life.
Yes. I'm guessing he's making a song sort of inspired by the tale that we just heard. That was good. I want to look at the credits and see who produced this song. This is the best song so far. By far, like, this, yes, this is what I wanted. This is what I wanted. Yes. This sounds more 70s than 80s, which I love the 70s, so it makes sense that I love this album. I mean, this song.
Don't you dare touch that dial, because like the song says, you are out of time. Dawn FM.
What? Yes. I love. Yes. What's Tyler gonna do on this song? Is he gonna, did he produce this? This sounds like the song where people are dancing, like prom or something. Yeah, I don't love when he has this kind of flow. I like when he sings, but this is cute. Cause I love the production. Very reminiscent of what Silk Sonic is doing right now. Make a scream like Nev Campbell. I told myself that I never fall. But here we go again. Yes, singer.
This love is strong to me. Some things can change, go wrong with me.
Okay, that was so quick.
Forever is too long to me. You gon' sign this prenup. You gon' sign this prenup.
What?
You gon' sign this prenup. You gon' sign this prenup.
Not him hypnotizing the person to sign the prenup. This chorus is so beautiful. If he had Victoria Monet instead of Tyler on this song, and I know I keep mentioning people, but like, if he had Victoria Monet on this song, this would be a hit. Right now, I think it's good. I like the chorus, but the verses are not that strong. Mm. This is Best Friends, track 9. Not me being the radio presenter. He loves that. I can already tell you the artist that needs to be on this song. Kali Uchis. The beat is made for Kali Uchis. Come on, Flo. I love it when my dad. Don't try to like that. Focus on the future. You don't want to have sex as friends no more. What? Friends no more. Ooh, friends no more. What? Sex as friends no more. You don't want to have sex as friends no more. How do you friends? I guess with benefits. Well, we love knowing yourself. He said, I'm too clumsy. Don't put me. Oh my god. That was a short song. That was one of the good ones. I enjoyed that. Come on, DJ. Best Friends was cute. Yeah, I enjoyed it. Like I said, could have done with the Kali Uchis. Was too short. But it was cute. I liked it. Does that say, is there someone else on Mars or online? Don't be sir, someone loyal to me. Don't you think I see? What? I don't want to be a prisoner to who I used to be. We can all change, the Weeknd. We can all change. You don't have to be a prisoner to who you once were. Forever's a long time. Is there someone else on Mars? If those are not the lyrics, then what can I say? Those should have been the lyrics. Yeah, this does not need a feature. This is good. Oh, it definitely said Mars. Did you hear? That sounded like a spaceship moving. Is There Someone Else is definitely one of my favorites. So, he's in love, you guys. This is Starry Eyes, but it still sounds like the previous song, so. Oh, this is beautiful. Let me be there. Let me be there. Okay. I guess this is an interlude. He is cynical. After Hours is a very cynical album. That's what I was saying. This album sounds so much more optimistic than the last one. And it sounds like he's saying to this person, that's who I used to be, and this is who I am now. Take me for what I am, not who I used to be. I don't know who said that. Someone said that once in a song. Moving on to the 12th track, Every Angel is terrifying. Why are angels terrifying, sir? Okay. I won't lie, I'm ready to dance again. We don't need to go now slow for the whole album.
On the angels' order, even if they pressed me against their heart,
who's talking?
I'd be consumed.
Okay. Oh. Let's go dance.
Edgy.
Oh, I guess we're transitioning to a different time in the radio station, so we're gonna have songs that sound different again.
Cinema like you've never seen it before.
Yes. Yes. Yes to this production.
I see you drowning in the pearl lights. Ooh. Now they shine bright.
This sounds so fluid.
On you. I think that you would die for me.
Mm-hmm.
Destiny. And this time I know for sure. Just don't break my heart.
Yes.
Don't you break my heart.
So it sounds like on this song he is addressing where his cynicism comes from, why he's so cynical, why he has been the way that he is, and he's leading into love with proportion, you know, which most people should do, I think. I'll tell you, the production is what I love the most about this song. The beginning was very, very, very good. As it went on, I was like, okay, it's cute. I don't know if I want to keep this heart next to it. It's nice, but I'm just like, I don't know if I love it like that, like that. This is I Heard You're Married featuring Lil Wayne. That's a very Michael Jackson note. I don't know. I'm not really feeling this one, guys. It's back to like the sounds that we were at in the beginning. It's not bad. I'm just like, okay. I like that. It has parts that I like. You should not play with married people. Don't do it. That's true. Ooh. Love that.
Can't be your side, bitch. That shit ain't fly, bitch. Can't be your pilot. Can't be your private. I thought we were some lovebirds, canaries. But I can't fuck with you.
I thought we were some lovebirds, canaries.
I got a ton of shit. And when Doug's crying, we ain't got enough to shoot. Tell hubby I kill him, no hubcap.
No. Lil Wayne should have not been on that song. No. Wait, is Lil Wayne singing? He sounds good, actually. Maybe that's all he should have done. Because the verse, it just sounds misplaced.
I can't be with you. You're too deceiving.
Yeah, this like outro part. Mm-hmm. The only problem I have with all these songs is they just sound way too similar. Tell me how this song is different from Sacrifice. It's not. That's how. Anyway, we're on to the 15th track. It's called Less Than Zero. This sounds like that song that he has with Ariana. What is it called?
I play your heart like a symbol.
I forgot what it's called now.
I know. I'll always be less than zero.
at this point, I am tired and bored. I'm sorry, I don't wanna lie. I'm not like, I was tired, but I heard you're married. Maybe the chorus will be better. Let me have faith. Just like, I've heard it with this ding 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 ding. I've heard it. I like the chorus. It sounds like something that would be on a movie. But yo, I'm tired. Yo, yo. Also, why is this album so long? Yo, I just, maybe we can. Who knows? The chorus is really good. I like it. I can't lie and say to the people that I'm still bored. I like the chorus. I do. He knows that's the best part of the song. Uh-huh, that's cute. You know, if this song was more guitar heavy, I might have liked it. That last part, excuse me, was actually good. This is Phantom Regret by Jim. I'm guessing that's Jim Carrey.
You're tuned to Don FM. The middle of nowhere on your dial. You may be here a while. Now that all future plans have been postponed, were you ever in tune with the song Life Was Humming? And if your broken heart's heavy when you step on the scale, you'll be lighter than air when they pull back the veil. You don't reach for bliss. God knows life is chaos.
You don't reach for bliss. Come on, poetry. You know what? I do agree with you, Jim. I do think heaven is not a place that you reach for. It's a place that you're at. Like, you're not gonna get to heaven. You are the heaven. That brings us to the conclusion of this long ass album. Okay, I'm sorry, Abel. This did not need to be that long. Now, I will say, I appreciate any artist that puts themselves out any and every time they do, because I realize it takes a lot of work, it takes a lot of time to do this. However, this was tiresome to listen to. The songs, there was not a bad song. Except for I Heard You're Married. You know, that one was a little, I really didn't enjoy that. But, and Less Than Zero, like, the last two, I was not feeling, but I think I was just tired. I don't think the songs are bad. There's no bad song. But the good songs are very few and far between. That's the problem. The songs I put a heart next to is Take My Breath, Out of Time, Is There Someone Else, and Don't Break My Heart. Now, Don't Break My Heart, I'm not sure about, because towards the middle of the song, I was like, okay. But out of 16 songs, only four, for me were good, which means what, 25%? Only 25% of the songs are like good, like great. That's a bit of a problem, Abel. So all I'm gonna say is, this album was not bad. I'm probably never going to listen to this album ever again. But that's it. That's all I have to say. I think it's time for another shift. It's time for another shift. It's time for us to go somewhere else. Let's pick another era. Maybe the 60s. You know, maybe the 90s. Maybe we can look forward in a whole new way. Think of what FKA Twigs is doing. And you were on her album. I mean, on her song. The last song I reacted to, I think, was The Weeknd and FKA Twigs. Look at what she's doing. Maybe try to go into that. I don't know. But this, I don't think this is it. I don't think this is it. That's it for my reaction. If you have any, first of all, if you're here by the end of this, if you're still watching, hi, bestie. And if you are, if you have any requests for albums, tell me. People have been requesting songs and people that I don't like, and I don't want to react to things that I know I don't like, because I'm not trying to spread hate on this internet. So please request, but know that I might not react to it. If you have any comment on the video I made and my thoughts, or if you have any thoughts on the songs themselves, please comment them down below. Give this video a like if you liked it, and I will see you on the next one. Goodbye.